a trial that I've said and that I believe at this time is the most important in the world because it involves crimes of immense proportions, the alleged killing of at least 1.7 million people, a crime that still has an effect on everyone in this country. People would like to see this tribunal finish at the end of case two, but that is not a political decision. The decision is to be made by this court according to the statute, according to the law, according to the facts that are developed. And so that's what we want to see respected. I mean, in all of the international justice institutions that we talk about, there are people out there, there are people today criticizing the ICC's indictment of Gaddafi, including chiefs of state of member states of the ICC. People are expressing views, and what we say is whatever the views of these individuals are, the rules, the orders of these courts need to be followed, and that's what we're asking for. Hundreds had been killed, and certainly since then, by Gaddafi's forces, thousands have been killed. And so now a decision has been made, and under UN Security Council Resolution 1970, you know, all states are urged to cooperate with the court, and Libya specifically is mandated to cooperate with the court, as are the member states of the ICC, and we're looking for that to happen. And I think the signal, as I said, of what happened here in case two, with these senior leaders coming to trial after a long period of time, what happened a month ago with Ratko Mladic on the run for 15 years, being brought to being arrested in Serbia and taken to The Hague, is a signal that if you commit these crimes, there'll be consequences.